Hey, what is going on, guys? In this video, I will explain how to delay heavy tasks in order to improve response time of specific endpoints. Good examples of such tasks would be send notification to user, for instance via email or SMS, send a request to external system, any heavy data calculation. Examples of tasks that most probably shouldn't be delayed: modify data that should be present in response. For instance, you return customer's information and later you update it. The problem is that the endpoint will return not updated information. Save data in database or any other storages. This task shouldn't be delayed because you would probably want to return an error in case data wasn't stored. Not time-consuming parts of main business logic. It does not make sense to delay such tasks as your code will become more complicated and it will be more difficult to understand it. You can delay tasks by using kernel terminate event or component messenger. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how you can achieve this by using kernel terminate event. You can find link to my tutorial about messenger component in the description and somewhere in the top right corner. Let's start from how event kernel terminate works. This event is triggered when response is already sent to the client. It means that client has received response from the server, and now you can perform any time-consuming tasks without worry that client will wait too long. Be aware that at this point you can no longer change your response. This approach is quite simple and powerful, but I want to mention that internally Symfony uses PHP function fuzzy.gi.finish.request, which works only with PHP FPM server API. If you use different server API, this approach will work, but you will get no benefit out of it, because response will be sent to the client only when all tasks from kernel terminate event have completed. Okay, there are also some pitfalls with the kernel terminate event, and they might confuse you, especially if you use it for the first time. This event contains request and response, but no controller context. Another thing, it is triggered after each request. I want to stress one more time: after each request. I will explain with example. User wants to get information about his reservation by providing a reservation ID. Every time user fetches this information, the external system should receive some tracking notification. Let's say this external system is unreliable and can process requests very slowly. So, to not block a user, we will send notification using kernel terminate event. Let's jump deeply into details. I have prepared a project in GitHub, so you can use it to follow this tutorial. The link is available in the description. Open the project. I have entity reservation and root to retrieve information about single object. Let's open the controller. Here we get reservation ID from request, get repository for reservation entity, and find entity in database using this ID. Throw exception in case it's not found. Then create DTO out of object, and then return all information about this reservation. After response is returned, we want to send a notification to external service with reservation data. First, create a listener which will listen to a kernel terminate event. Name it on reservation retrieval listener. Define public method on kernel terminate. It should process only master request and skip all sub-requests. As I mentioned earlier, kernel terminate event is called after each request. It means that this listener will be triggered after each endpoint. Let me demonstrate. To enable this listener, we should define it as a service and set tag with name kernel event listener. And then specify event type which we want to listen to. In our case, it's kernel terminate. Then specify method name which will be called. Open root's YAML. I will duplicate existing endpoint and rename root. And also I will change its path. Go back to the listener and set a breakpoint. To launch application, simply run make up, and it will launch database, Nginx, and run migration with sample data. Now you can enable debugger. Switch to routes YAML and copy path. Now we should send a request. For this I use application postman. Type host and paste the path. SID set 1. Send request. And you see that our listener was called and event contains request and response objects. Now copy path from second route and send request one more time. And our listener is called again. We can stop debugger and remove breakpoint. So, to not execute our code for all endpoints, we should filter out all unnecessary calls. We can do it in different ways, for example, by checking request method type. But more specific would be to check root name. This is a unique name which you define for endpoint. If you open roots YAML, you will find there the same definition. Let's skip only this check. There is a command to get list of all defined listeners by event type. You can run it to check if you configured your listener correctly. Once endpoint is identified, we should send a notification to external service with reservation data. And for this we should somehow get a reservation object. I will just call notExiting method, which I will define later, and it should return us a reservation. Then we transform object to a structure and add a new property for transformer. Now we send request to the service and also add a new property for API client. It's always a good idea to catch errors. Don't ignore them. Instead, log all errors to be able to keep track on them in your application. And also add property for the logger. At the end we can do something with response. Now let's define a method getReservation. In kernel terminate event we don't have a controller's context. So we also don't have a reservation object which we have retrieved earlier. But we can get ID from request and fetch reservation by this ID from database. So this method will accept a request object from which we will get the ID. Then we will use entity manager to get a reservation by this ID. Specify a return type and add the property for the entity manager. Also pass request into the method. And finally, I would add types for all properties and create a constructor for all dependencies. Don't forget to set them in the service definition. Let's test it. Put a breakpoint and run debugger. Switch to Postman and send request to the endpoint to get reservation. We stopped in the listener. This is a master request, so we continue. Passed a root check. Let's step into get reservation method. And here we got reservation ID and fetched object from database. Got generated DTO and sent a notification to the service. Now let's test how this listener will behave for another endpoint. Switch to Postman and send request to endpoint something else. We also stopped in the listener. But this time the check didn't pass. Let's check what is the value in root parameter. As you see, root name doesn't match. This example was quite simple, but imagine a situation when we create a new reservation from request. Then this task became more complicated, because we should somehow get newly created reservation in the listener. Let's look at this case. Switch to reservation controller. I will close other tabs because they distract me. Add a new method createAction. It will create a form type, process request through form, return an error in case of invalid request, save result into the database, create DTO and return it in response. Open file roots YAML. Add a new route for create endpoint. Duplicate existing listener. Name it OnReservation Creation Listener and also rename class. Scroll to root check. Change root name to the new one. As for now, pass event object into the method and go to the method declaration. Now we should somehow get credit reservation. As a solution, we can get reservation ID from response, but it will work only if response contains this ID. So we get whole content from response and parse it as JSON. Then we check if it contains ID, and if yes, fetch reservation from database with this ID. And now we should pass response into the method. Another solution would be to create intermediate service where we can set and retrieve reservation object. So in the controller we will set it, and in the listener we retrieve this object back. This intermediate service will be kind of storage container. There are only two methods, one to set reservation and another one to get it. Switch to reservation controller and add reservation storage into create action. Once reservation is stored, we set it into storage service. Now go into the listener and replace entity manager with reservation storage. We don't need entity manager anymore, as it was used only for previous example. And finally, in the method getReservation, we retrieve reservation object from storage service. And also, it's not necessary to set reservation manually. You can use doctrines prepersist or preupdate events and set reservation into service once it's persisted or updated. I have summarized pros and cons of using kernel terminate event. The advantage is that the implementation is relatively simple and doesn't require any QoS services. On the other hand, it works only for PHP FPM Server API and often requires some workarounds. Also be aware of FPM max children limitation. This is FastCGI option that sets the limit on the number of simultaneous requests that will be served. Yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like it, then make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, feel free to join my Telegram chat. I will try to help you. Cheers!